put upon that he should be the head of the world was not up to Abraham or his seed through the law, but through the righteousness of faith. But with they which are of the law, behind faith is made void, and the promise made of no effect. Because the law works wrath, for there is no law in you, there is no transgression. But therefore, it is for faith that it might be by grace to the end, the promise might be sure to all the seed, not to that only which is of the law, but to that also which is of faith, of Abraham, who is the father of all. As it is written, I have made you a father of many nations before him whom he believed, even God, who quickened the dead and called those things which be not as though they were. Who again hope believed in hope that he might believe become the father of many nations, according to that which was spoken, so shall that seed be. And being not weak in faith, he considered not his own body now dead when he was about 100 years old. Neither yet the dead of several wounds. He staggered not at the promise of God through the unbelievers, but was strong in faith and gave glory to God, and then was sure that what he had promised he was able to perform, and there it was and put for him for righteousness. Now it was not written for his sake alone that it was input to him, but for us also, to whom it shall be input, if we believe on him that raised us Jesus our Lord from the dead, who delivered from our office and was risen again for our justification. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, church. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, Holy Father. I'm going to break it down to you for this. I'm trying to break it down for you to understand a little bit this morning. The Lord will. I just want to tell God thank you, Father God. The first to say, he said, for Abraham and his descendants received a promise. Abraham and his descendants received a promise that they would gain the whole world. That they would gain the whole world. He did not receive the promise through the law. Through the law, but through being right with faith. Being right with faith. Being right with faith by faith. If people could receive God's promise by the law, if people could receive the promise through being right with the following the law, then the promise would be having no effect. The promise would be no effect on the promise. If they by the law, if they follow the law, if people could receive what God promised by following the law, then the faith is worth it. But if it be worth it, it won't be worth nothing. It's by the law. And God promised to Abraham won't be worth nothing. So we receive the promise by faith now. It ain't by the law. Don't let people try to fool you, it's by the law, it's by the promise. The faith. By faith. Because the law can only bring God anger. The law can only bring God anger. But if there is no law, there is nothing to disobey. See, the law is gone. It's all about faith. It's all about faith. So the law is only bring God anger. The law, the only thing God ain't, but if there is no law, there is nothing to disobey. Nothing that. So we got to understand, we got to have faith. If you ain't got faith in you, you by the law, it's worth. It's not worth. Verse 16. All right. So people receive God's promise by having faith. This happens so the promise can be a free gift. The promise can be a free gift. Then all Abraham's children can have that promise. It was not only for Abraham's children to have that faith, but anyone who has a faith like that or Abraham. That like Abraham had, who is the father of them all. You gotta have faith. See, people think it's all about everything there, but it's all about faith. Who Abraham, he the father of all. We're descendants. Oh, we're descendants. We are Abraham's descendants. We all got that promise now. We all got to live by what? Faith. And who? God. God promise. That's what we're so good about. Verse 17 says, as it was written in the scripture, I am making you a father of many nations. This is true before who? God. True before God. They told Abraham, I'm going to make you a father of, as it's written, I'm going to make you a father of many nations. Many nations. Many nations. This is true before God. The God that Abraham, the God that Abraham believed, the God who gave life to the dead, and who created some out of nothing. Created some out of nothing. Gave life to the dead. Abraham believed in this faith. You see what I'm saying? As it was written, he told Abraham, I'm going to make you a father of many nations. Many nations. Many nations. You know, Abraham, he couldn't have no children. You see how God can do things. All you got to what? Believe. That faith. Have that faith in God. When you just think about when you have this pain, you like you don't gave up. On yourself. Well, I'm going to stay in the bed all day. I'm hurting this morning. Don't get up and try to do something for the Lord. Don't devil go, well, you stay home today. It don't work that way. God to have faith in him. With faith, without faith, you can't do nothing. God ain't going to work with you without faith, church. I don't know what's wrong with people now. They put all on sickness. And all this, you ain't got to put nothing on the sickness. You just ask God for the strength. Go devil will throw you back in your bed. When you get out of the bed, he throw you right back down in your bed of sleep. Every time. You got to make the devil out of life.
Hallelujah.
See, when you make the devil out of life, when you make that devil out of life, he don't like that. He don't like that, church. He don't like that stuff. We put everything, on you not coming to church and stuff. You got to think about Abraham. See, our problem, we ain't got the faith that Abraham had. But we always want God to do something for us. We always want God to do something for us, but we don't want to do nothing for God. That's all we heard this morning, our headache or something. I'm going to stay home. See, we gotta make the devil out of life. And I see you coming, devil. Every time the devil come to Jesus on the mountain. Paul said, you're the son of God. Let the throne be great. Come on, church. Because you be the Son of God, make this throne be upright.
Yeah.
Jesus said, a man can't live by bread alone. So you got to quote, you got to get the devil down the scripture. After a while, the devil leave you. But I tell you one thing, he's going to come back. He's going to come back to you again. Sooner or later, he's going to try you again.
Yeah.
You got me this time. But after a while, he's going to come right back to you. It might not be today, but he's going to come back to you tomorrow sometime. I got you now. When you kneel down to him, he said, I got you again. I know I can get you in my corner again.
Amen.
So you got to learn how to shake the devil off.
Hallelujah.
If you don't know how to shake that devil off, then he can use you.
That's right.
But so you said, when he's getting ready to use you, you got to use the word of the Lord on him.
Yeah.
You got to get that devil with that strip. He can't stand that strip. That's our problem now.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. Every little pain we had, we gotta let it heal it up, and don't know how to kneel down and tell the Lord, help me, give me more strength.
Amen.
When I go in the woods by myself, I say, Lord, give me strength.
Mm-hmm.
I say, Lord, give me strength. Don't let nothing happen to me in the woods.
Yeah.
So you gotta know how to get God. Get the devil out of the way and get God to pray.